mgomo huu muda wote kutoka sasa. Tukisalia katika swala lilo hilo, muungano wa wafanyikazi binafsi nchini KEPSA umetoa wito wa kuweko kwa suluhu la dharura kufuatia mgomo wa wafanyikazi wa mamlaka ya viwanja vya ndege nchini KAA katika uwanja wa ndege wa kimataifa wa Jomo Kenyatta. Kupitia kwa mwenyekiti wao Caroline Kariuki, muungano huo uliwalaumu wafanyikazi wa JKIA kwa kuandaa mgomo bila kumaliza mbinu zote haswa ambazo zilifaa kufuatwa ili kupata suluhu. Caroline alikuwa akizungumza katika uzinduzi wa kongamano la kina mama katika fani ya usimamizi wa wafanyikazi huko Naivasha.
The focus now on the whole issue of the 50-50 is to look at not only remuneration, but what are the challenges that women face in the workspace. I was giving an example of mostly lactating mothers, how sometimes they do not focus at work or they take a break, and how we address that by lactation rooms, mothers' rooms and all that. So looking at some of the challenges that women in different seasons of their lives face and how to really mitigate those gaps. That's the only way we'll get to this 50-50, and then looking at how to create opportunities that that women can take over. But again, I also said something that we're living in an interesting time when the whole idea of emotional intelligence is really a big thing right now, and women can take advantage of that because we see it's an area that women are highly gifted in, and so if they use that skill, they could take more opportunities than ever, any other time in history. I think it's premature because the discussions around KQKAA are going on. Nothing has been put in place. Nothing has been decided on that discussion. And at the same time, I think the KAA, the leadership has been very, and KQ, that this will not lead to jobs being lost, you know, and that has been communicated. So for me, I think it was a premature strike. They needed to have waited and to see what's on the table before they can react.
And some of the issues that have come to the fore are issues to do with the remuneration of women who are in HR, you know, the disparities really between male and female. Some of it has been really self-perception, that not that these women are not capable, they are, but how do they perceive themselves so that they believe in themselves that they are capable to do so. And some of it is that opportunities do arise, but they are not willing to take it up. Generally, in our analysis of even the data we have at IHRM of HR professionals, women are rising up to a certain level. They would rise up to HR manager. They will not climb up to chief HR officer or director of HR in a blue chip company or listed companies.